Let us pray. We lift our hearts and minds in prayer to you, O God, in this new Advent season of the church year, when we prepare a way within us for the coming of your messianic reign. Remind us of your promises in Torah and the prophets, and particularly in the words and life of Christ Jesus, that your judgment and blessing are sure. You are the true source of justice, righteousness, and merciful grace. So let us approach Christmas this year with truth and hope in our hearts. Although our minds are only partially aware, we share your grief at the magnitude of suffering around the world. From the wars in Afghanistan and the Middle East, to the violence in Africa and the Americas, we see how cruel and brutal human beings can be, often in perverse claim of serving you. The conflict of good and evil here on earth seems apocalyptic, with forces of terror and death often seeming to gain the upper hand. Here at home, deaths, especially of boys and young men of color, in Ferguson, Staten Island, and across the country, expose our nation's bondage to ignorance, fear, and insecurity. Again and again, police, almost always white, say they fear for their lives, while communities of color naturally see police as a deadly threat, especially to their sons. As a people, even in the church, we cannot see the ways poverty and racism have left us all blind, so that our acts flail murderously in the dark, inflicting destruction and death. God, forgive us, for we know not what we do. Help us, especially in the church, to see ourselves and others as you see us, O God. Help us learn your ways of peace and justice that overcome our prejudice and fear. Let your justice roll down like waters, and your righteousness like an ever-flowing stream, until all of us realize that only in your love can we find peace. Not in even more guns or tanks or drones or explosives, not in kidnapping, massacres, or beheadings, not in more and more prisons and fences along our borders, not in accumulating more and more wealth for ourselves. No, we can find peace only in your love, the love that brought us all into being, infinitely and wondrously diverse, but made in your image, your children, brothers and sisters, one family, charged with the responsibility not to exploit others or resources, but to be your loving stewards, making life better for future generations. Bless this city, O God, so that we may be the light shining towards a better way for our country and the world. Bless our congregation as we seek to be faithful disciples of Christ Jesus, speaking truth to power, and caring for the bereaved, the sick and imprisoned, the immigrant, the hungry and homeless, the thirsty as far as away as Haiti and beyond, so that we become a truly beloved and loving community. All this, and the silent prayers in each of our hearts, we lift up to you this first Sunday of Advent, in Jesus' name. Amen.